I'd like to be able to do more for my employees. I'd like to see them to be able to earn more money. I'd like to be able to see us add more employees. With the ever-increasing cost to me as the employer, in order to do that, it affects my bottom line. So the higher the rates go, the less it is that we're able to do as far as the profitability of the company. And the factor is, the market controls what we can charge. So in an hourly rate, I can't just keep increasing my hourly rate to the consumer every time I see an increase from L&I or some of these other agencies. So I would like to see that reduction not only in our rates, but L&I as an entity, if they can do what we have to do as small business and tighten our reins, become more efficient, we have to do that as a small business. Why don't they as a department?
Some of the things I'd like to see or really need to be fixed within L&I itself is there's no accountability for claims, for poor claims management decisions. Claims go on and on and on. It's difficult to speak with anybody there. That's reasonable to get a reasonable answer or to get problems fixed. They have policies that completely counter, that they use that completely counter WAC codes, which makes it impossible for an employer to do it right. And it's really the way the rate keeps going up, even at 0% increases, the logging industry still takes a 6% hit last year, 11% the year before, and that was on two back-to-back years of 0%. We can't afford that. It's unsustainable for our industry, and at some point the industry is going to fail. A good example is in the last 3 years, my experience rates dropped 12%. My cost, which means my cost should go down with that, but my cost has gone up 20% with those rate increases, so I can't keep up. I can't get that rate down low enough, fast enough. And a big part of that is like poor claims management. Oh, it's a nightmare.
And in Oregon, it's privatized. He competes with a company on the other side of the border that is $19.62 an hour less because they privatized it. And it's amazing to me that we haven't had rig reform, and I'm not for rig reform. I'm for replacing L&I with a private company.
We have a monopoly on employees' compensation here in the state. There's been no, where every business has to reduce their costs, look for ways to economize. We can economize with that cost. It just keeps going up and up and up. There's no reason for it to be going up when the economy is going down. The only reason is the huge bureaucracy that's there and the process they go through to set up claims and pay claims. And if you talk to the employees on the other side that have gone through it, almost all of them think it's an awful experience to go through. And almost everything else in our life, there's private insurance that covers it. This, we're forced to go through a government bureaucracy to insure ourselves and to take care of the employees. And it's just the wrong way to go. It needs to be changed.
It's the system isn't, and it doesn't help small, I have a bunch of small business clients. One was making reels and stuff, and they just keep upping the rate, and to my knowledge, most of the people haven't had any claims, but it doesn't matter because their cost of doing business with L&I, because there's no incentive to do it less expensively like there is in private industry, it just keeps going up. We were at like 90,000 in 2010, 2011, 2012, we were 117,000, and we've hired less, we have less employee worked hours because we're Teamster, we provide really good benefits, we got medical, dental, and that's another thing, if you provide medical, they end up giving the guy more eventually, but we are having trouble getting more drivers because unemployment's too lucrative. And so we've been doing what we call rent-a-driver. When you rent, when you buy from an employment agency, you're not paying L&I. So that $117,000 compared to 90 is on lesser hours. And quote from the papers, quote from the governor, quote from everybody, we got a 0% increase. That's not true.